Today I'm going to discuss an important reaction in organic chemistry. The name of this reaction is ozonolysis. Ozonolysis is a splitting of an unsaturated molecule in the presence of ozone. The unsaturated molecule can be an alkene or an alkyne, and the product of this reaction is usually a carbonyl compound which can be an aldehyde or a ketone. A general outlook of this reaction looks a bit like this. Let's start our discussion with the prediction of the products of the reaction. Here I have shown an alkene. The double bond of this alkene will break in the presence of an ozone molecule, and it will generate two carbonyl compounds. These two carbonyl compounds have two oxygens from the ozone, and the third oxygen of ozone will be extracted from dimethyl sulfide in the form of dimethyl sulfoxide. Let's see some other examples of this reaction and try to predict the products of these reactions. And the products are shown here as this. Before going into too much detail of the reaction, let us study the structure of an ozone molecule. The ozone molecule is a dipolar molecule. As you can see, there is a negative charge and a positive charge on adjacent oxygen atoms. But it is a special type of a dipolar molecule. Let us see how. This is the oxygen 1, this is oxygen 2, and this is oxygen 3, as you can consider. Now let's see the delocalization of this negative charge over this ozone molecule. This negative charge will shift between these two oxygen atoms, and the double bond will be shifted to the third oxygen, and we will have the other resonance structure of this molecule as this. As you can see, the negative charge has gone to the third oxygen atom, and this negative charge will come back to the first oxygen atom by these steps as I have shown here. Now, as I have shown, the negative charge resides on the terminal atoms having 1-3 relation, and the central atom has the localized positive charge. As you can see, the oxygen atom in the center has positive charge in both of the canonical forms. It means it's not going anywhere, it's just residing on the central oxygen atom. So the molecule is a dipole with a negative charge residing on the atoms which have 1-3 relationship. So such molecules are known as 1-3 dipoles. There are some other examples of these 1-3 dipoles or 1-3 dipolar compounds. One of these is azide, the other one are the nitro compounds, then comes the nitrones, and finally we have the diazo compounds. Moreover, there are many other examples of the dipolar molecules. After having the basic introduction of the ozone molecule and the basic understanding of the overall reaction of ozonolysis, now we can start studying the mechanism of this reaction. Let's start with an alkene and the ozone molecule. The negative charge of the ozone molecule will attack on the carbon of the alkene, and in response to that, the double bond of the alkene will attack the other terminal oxygen of the ozone, and the double bond between two oxygen atoms will be shifted to the central positively charged oxygen. This reaction is known as 1-3 dipolar cycle addition, and it will yield a 5-membered ring which is highly unstable and known as molozonide. The molozonide, being unstable, will undergo a reverse 1-3 dipolar cycle addition to generate a ketone or an aldehyde and a dipolar compound, and this dipolar compound is known as nitrone. Now let's see how does it work. The dipolar compound will rotate by 180 degrees, and now it will attack the carbonyl compound just like the ozone attacked the unsaturated alkene. Similarly, this nitrone will attack the unsaturated carbonyl compound, which may be an aldehyde or a ketone. And when it will happen, there will be another 1,3 dipolar cycloaddition. And it will happen like this. And the product will be much more stable than molozonide, and it is known as ozonide. The oxygen between the two carbon atoms will be abstracted by the dimethyl sulfide molecule, and the reaction will occur like this. And the dimethyl sulfide molecule, after abstracting the oxygen from the ozonide, will leave as dimethyl sulfoxide, and there will be two remaining carbonyl compounds, which may be aldehydes and ketones, which are the actual products of the ozonolysis reaction. So that's it for today.